My name is Matt Millar. I'm the regional director for Sub-Saharan Africa with an organization called New Thing. We help churches to start churches that will start churches that will start more churches. I'm from the U.S., but I've lived in Kenya now for 10 years. I'm the last born of three boys. We grew up going to church every Sunday. We went to church. And then Sunday afternoons, there was children's discipleship that we were going through. So church was a part of life, but it was not our entirety. I would tell people that I was saved, but I wasn't following Jesus as Lord. I didn't realize the distinction until much later. Fast forward into early adolescent, maybe 13, my God was sports. And I was very good at American sport called baseball. I was very good until I got injured and I couldn't play anymore. And now all of a sudden I didn't know what to do with myself. If I'm not good at baseball and I can't play, how will people ever like me or love me? That was the introduction to an identity crisis that led me to drinking, drugs, women. And so from the age of 14 up till 24, I was living a very wayward lifestyle, living very much in the world and not even going to church anymore. Although I would still pray, I still considered myself saved. Obviously Jesus was not somebody that I was thinking about. I was not having any relationship with him. Fast forward now to 2006. My second born brother was a US Marine. He fought the war in Iraq, came back, had PTSD. So he was back physically, but wasn't the same person that I knew him as. And that was kind of the first jab or the first cut at our family and my relationships and things that were dearest to me. A few months after that, my oldest brother told me he was gonna get divorced from his wife. They'd only been married 3 months, but they had dated 9 years. The same night he told me that, he told me that my father had just had an affair with my mom's best friend. My oldest brother and my father were people that I looked up to very much. I thought they could do nothing wrong, and now I'm realizing that they aren't maybe the men that I thought they were. So both my brothers and my father, these older men that I looked up to, are now having issues. And I was still drinking heavily, very heavily. So now I'm in university. I was drinking, doing drugs, doing all the things that people in universities often do. And some months, not very long after that, actually, I got arrested. I got arrested for drinking and driving. That led me to being kicked off the baseball team in university, which was really the only reason that I went to university in the first place. I didn't really care much for the degree. I just wanted to play baseball. And then a few weeks after that, the girl I was dating broke up with me. So now all of these things that were important, all of these things that I counted on, all of these things that were secure, were broken and were no longer what I thought they were. And now I felt very much alone. I looked at my life and I realized this isn't the life that I want. If I keep making these decisions, this is where I'm going to end up, and I don't want to end up there. And so at that point in time, I knew that I needed to start really following Jesus. So I found a church near my university. I started reading the Bible. I started praying. I got connected to a small group. And over the course of 2 years, I finally got sober. I was very much tied into that life of partying and drinking and drugs. And it took me about 2 years. I had one Christian friend, and so it took me a while, and just the leading of the Holy Spirit telling me how to get free from alcohol and drugs. So 2009, I remember very specifically sitting down and saying, Jesus, what is this feeling that I'm feeling? I don't understand it. I don't recognize it. And I heard the Holy Spirit say, it's joy. I had been depressed for so long, I didn't recognize joy when it came up. And nothing was going on specifically. It was just the joy of the Lord that came up from within me. And it was amazing. It was shortly thereafter that I heard God calling me into full-time vocational ministry, which meant, you know, everybody's called to ministry, everybody's called to mission, but I knew I was supposed to specifically serve God within a vocational aspect. I didn't know if that meant, you know, an NGO, a church, or what have you. But my life took a dramatic and drastic change in the other direction from what I had been living through secondary school and through university. And now here I am serving as a missionary in Africa.